Would you like to have a car with the features I will list? You buy it once. You start using it. You take it to the service after 3 months. The service replaces all worn parts free of charge. You go back 6 months later, the worn-out parts are replaced again. With new parts every 2 years, you have a zero-kilometer car. And after 3 to 5 years, there are no parts of the car that remain unchanged, including the metal parts and the engine. Almost all of them are renewed free of charge. And it always goes on like this. Is there such a car brand? Of course not, but humans are such a being. It is constantly renewed. Each person consists of approximately 35 trillion living cells. In total, 70 to 80 billion cells die every day. A copy is created instead. How much does 70 to 80 billion cells make? One cell is 1 nanogram. 70 to 80 billion cells weigh about 80 grams. Something like that. My total volume of cells changes every day. Cells equal to the volume of meat on this plate are renewed every day. A total of 80 grams for a 70-pound person. Let's imagine that there are different types of cells that change inside, including blood cells. The outer layer of my eyes, the cornea, is renewed every 10 to 14 days. It regenerates faster when damaged or scratched. The cells in our skin change completely within 2 weeks, or at most a month. What does this mean? Our entire skin is renewed within a month at the latest. This is like repainting our car every month, not washing it once a month. Our stomach is in constant struggle. It deals with acids and food. Therefore, its inner wall is renewed in 2 days. If it is not excessively worn out, this renewal may take up to 9 days. The cells on the intestinal surface are completely renewed every 3 to 5 days. Taste receptor cells in my tongue are completely renewed in 10 to 14 days. The cells lining the airways in the lung are renewed every 2 to 3 weeks. My liver cells are completely renewed every 6 months, so my liver becomes a brand new liver every 6 months. We have between 100,000 to 150,000 hairs. These are constantly growing, like the growth of a plant, so it's changing. New ones emerge from the roots. Our skeleton is also renewed. There are partial regenerations, but it takes up to 10 years for the bones to be completely regenerated. Not only the neurons and nerve cells in my brain are renewed, but 80% of my body is completely renewed within 2 to 3 years. More precisely, almost all of my pieces are copied. 8 billion people live in the world. Now let's imagine a world like this. People work at home as a home office. Nobody leaves their house. The meals loved by the people living in that house are delivered to each house by motorized couriers. None of the 8 billion people goes hungry. No one has a livelihood problem. Everyone has a warm home. All houses are fully supplied with water and electricity. If he is sick, he is treated at home. The whole world has a common air conditioning system. Garbage is collected automatically. There are recycling units in every house. It is constant at the same temperature everywhere. It is not possible for such a world to be organized by humans. But man himself, with a population of 35 trillion cells, is like such a world. World population is 8 billion. There are 35 trillion cells in my body. There is this number of cells that need to be fed, like a human being. And these cells are not a single type. There are 200 different cells. Their foods are different from each other. The cells in my eye have different needs. The cells in my brain have different needs. The cells in my heart have different needs. The cells in my body survive with 20,000 different proteins. It maintains its vitality. These cells are taking in food, drinking water, and breathing at all times. They are all fully fed. This is what God's power and might are like. 35 trillion cells are fed fairly. There is not a single forgotten cell. There are 8 billion cells just at the tip of my little finger. If I were to shrink the people in the world to the size of a cell, they would fit into this small amount of space. With the system that God installed in my body, not 8 billion cells, but 35 trillion cells are fully nourished. 2.2 billion people in the world cannot find clean water. 2.3 billion people do not have adequate nutrition. 733 million people are at risk of hunger. What would our bodies be like if the nutrition of the human body was like the nutrition of people on Earth? I asked this to the artificial intelligence. I asked him what would happen if the cells in my body were nourished like people in the world, and I asked him to draw a picture of me nourished like that.
If the cells in your body had unequal nutritional conditions like people on Earth, some parts of your body would be healthy and strong, while others would be weak and malnourished. The muscles would become weak, and the skin would look pale and lifeless. Diseases would be more obvious. There could be wounds, inflamed or infected areas on the body. While one part of the body was highly developed, other parts remained weak and unbalanced.
But we are not like that. Our 35 trillion cells are fully nourished. The management of 35 trillion cells depends on a central authority. It's not up to us. Each cell has a special information processing center we call the nucleus. Each of our cells has a special power plant called mitochondria. There are ribosomes that produce whatever the cell needs. There are lysosomes, which are the most perfect recycling system. The cell handles logistics, packaging, and distribution. The Golgi apparatus does this. The cell needs water. There is a vacuole. It ensures water storage and water balance of the cell. We consist of 35 trillion cells that are fed, protected, and used in this way. These cells are constantly in motion. That's why we are always renewed. Imagine, you park your car in front of your house in the evening and go home. Someone picks it up and takes it to the service. Some parts are replaced, scratches are repaired, and washed. In the morning, I see that my car has been renewed. And without any fee. How surprised I would be? This is exactly what's happening in my body, but I don't know much about it. For this reason, we are not aware that we owe thanks to God for the renewals in our body that we are unaware of.